So hope everybody's keeping safe. And now, as you all know, I'm working on the Gerardo legs. I've already completed the inner frame for the lower part of the legs. Okay, and a few have been asking me how to actually make all the complicated masking right for these areas. So I'm going to show you how I approach it, in a sense of using selecting how to mask the layers as we go about. Okay, I'm going to use the upper thigh area as an example. So this is already painted, and these are prime using black surfacer. Okay, so what I normally do is, for example, I want to keep the black color. I'll just mask over some of the areas, as you can see here, right? There's one here, and there's another one inside there, a small piece. So like what I always do, cut out small pieces of cubes and then just stick it on there. And then how we approach a multi-layer object in terms of painting it is, go for the deeper one first, the lowest layer. So in this case, I'm going to paint the cylindrical shape here, right? I'm going to be painting that, masking that off, and then start to work my way up. Okay, so let's get to work on this. Okay, so we have already painted the cylinders, right? Let me move this up a bit. Okay, we've already painted the cylinders, and now we are going to be masking them out. Okay. Yeah, at least you can see it. So let me show you how I do the masking. Like what I normally do, right, I cut small pieces. Small strips. Okay. Oops. And start covering up the cylinder. So sometimes this area is a bit oddly shaped, like a triangle shape. So what I do is I just cut something similar to a triangle shape. Just insert it in there. And continue to mask these areas. With this type of masking technique, you can actually mask almost anything. Right? You can cover all aspects of masking in Gunpla. So, why you need to sort of like pay attention to inner frame is that it is a good platform for you to practice masking, because it is so complicated, and if you can do it well in your inner frame, right, you can do a good job in your armor pieces when you are painting it and masking it, right? And another thing, if you make a mistake in your inner frame, it doesn't matter because you'll be covering it up with your armor later, but at least you have a platform for you to practice. And the more you do it right, the simpler it becomes, because you're so used to doing it, and then you start to see how to tackle each piece once you're familiar with all this. Because once you move to resin, right, it is really for the external pieces. So for example, the propellant tanks and all that, it just comes in one piece and you really need to mask. See, that is done. Right. And I'll mask this top piece here as well. That piece is done. So I'll continue with the rest of the three pieces, and then we'll spray and we'll go to the next layer. Okay, we just sprayed our second color, burnt iron. So I'm gonna mask out the areas that I want to retain that color on top of what your original mask that you had there. Leave it there, so we continue to do our masking. Okay, so I'll just continue to mask off the other few areas and other pieces, and then we'll continue from there. Alright, so we've just finished masking off the second, third layer. Okay, so those are the places that we're keeping the burnt iron color. Next color that we're going to have is gold. So it'll just be around here and the insides of that circular sort of like joint. Okay, then we'll come back and we'll mask off the gold, and the final color will be the final color is robot iron. Okay, so that'll be the final color. Alright, so we are down to the last color. So we are going to be masking off the gold. Okay, this is the easiest one because it's all right on top, so it's pretty simple. Treat masking like playing with a jigsaw puzzle, and you won't feel bored. You're just basically trying to fill all the areas with small pieces of masking tape, right? Yeah. Okay, then I'll be masking out this area. Thank you. okay, we're done, right? So I'll finish off the other two pieces and then we'll spray it and we'll do the unveiling. Okay, final mask for the gold color, and then we're gonna be spraying robot iron next. Okay folks, so it's the unmasking time. Right, this is the moment of truth. But if you do mess up, don't worry, you can just touch up. Yeah. So we still have to do detailing work on it after removing all the masks. So all in all, it took me a couple of hours to complete these three parts. You can't really tell the difference between this color and this color, but if you look at it in proper light, right, you will actually see there's a quite a nice separation there. Okay, and we're done. So basically there are a few places I need to touch up, but other than that, overall it's done, it's completed. So I'll just need to add in more details, some panel lining, and we are good to go, right? So I hope this video helped you guys in terms of coming up with this painting for your own inner frame, right? Take care guys, have a good weekend, bye.